Oh, well, looky what we have here. Son of a fucking old bitch. I replaced this coolant hose because we had a leak, but it kept on leaking on me. Looks like we have a bad neck situation. Her neck went bad. Oh yeah, baby. Oh, look at this. Oh, she's pissing. She's a pissing. She's pissing out of this little piss hole. Now she's spurting over here. Oh boy, she's pissing. Let me let a little bit of coolant out of the pet cock. Today I'll be working on the money pit, and my son Kai will embark on his very own vehicular project. What a chip off the old cock.
Roll of them. Endless money pit.
He was hooking up a car in his daddy's garage.
Cockpit instrumentation.
Produced by Soundman and NVX Audio. Premium iPad dash kits and custom dash mods at soundman.co. High quality car stereo, amp speakers, and vehicle specific bass packages.
Bass!
NVX.com. We are also sponsored by US Alternators and downforsoundshop.com.
I'm gonna run and grab one of these. And I also got an airbag valve. Ooh, look at that half inch line having valve, baby. These are the switches this thing had in it when I got it. They were facing down like this, and they're on, off, ons. They're not momentaries. And we had a wonky one. I made this cool little switch panel for it. So we have an on for the compressor, and an up and down for the front, and an up and down for the back. The solenoid for the front up is bad. So the front just wants to continually lift. So we'll have to replace the front up valve. Then the bags will be perfecto. Perfecto mundo, baby. Shit, howdy, take a look at this, brother. $20. This is the AutoZone special, baby. That's the same damn turd that was on there, ain't it? I'm gonna take it and return it like this. Look.
You guys sold me some bunk shit.
We're gonna give this baby a little RTV for good luck. We're gonna go RTV, O-ring, and a little bit more RTV on the O-ring, baby. Creating an O-ring sandwich. Porno-fessional, baby.
Horny.
In other words, horny sapien. Chromosexual, baby, because it's chrome. That's one sexy chromo sapien. All right. I cleaned this surface off. Nice and swell. Get these threads started so that I can seat the neck. Seating neck.
One of the air ride valves took a dump. Hey, get it? If you're into working on cars, the great thing about owning a classic vehicle is you can go to bed with a fully working vehicle and wake up the very next morning with a project to work on for the day.
Look at that shit. I'll let that RTV dry for a little bit before I torque it down to specifications. To the OEM specifications, baby.
She's ready for pickup.
Look at this. Look at that.
Camera boy, also known as fitness boy, also known as muscle boy, bought himself a set of Mustang wheels. Look. Look what he did.
My son made me proud and bought himself a set of 18-inch wheels for his car without even knowing if they would fit. What if they don't fit?
He probably zipped those off.
Oh, now he's mad. Wait, hold on, muscle
boy, your microphone.
Why'd you do it backwards like that?
Do it backwards.
Put it on backwards. Okay. You shit.
Let me put it on. Let me mic you up the right way.
Put it on backwards. You don't even. Your eyes open?
Old wheels. Yeah. Yeah. So Muscle Boy is jacking up the vehicle.
This is Whack Jack.
There you go. Pump it.
How many reps is this?
How high are you gonna go?
Forever.
Jeez. Rest the jack on the
forever
door.
And ever. This is gay, dude.
Did you crack them loose first? Before?
Why you gotta do that anyways?
Because the wheel's gonna spin, Michael.
What do you gotta crack it for? Why can't this crack it?
You can try.
The weak-ass impact can't even crack the shit.
Well, you're supposed to crack it loose when the tire's on the ground.
I couldn't.
Then you jack it up.
Too many steps.
You hit it with the...
Way too many steps, B. Way too many.
Okay, Muscle Boy's in a hurry because he has to go to the gym and he's telling me to hurry up.
I can't even go to the gym
this
today.
This is his damn project. It has nothing to do with me. Give it a heave, Muscle Boy. Give it a heave.
It's weak ass.
Come on now, you're giving people a view of your butt cheeks.
Why'd you point the camera at him?
Give her a unloosen. You're winging your lug nuts all over the place.
Funny lug nut.
Give it a removal. Yeah, buddy. Now he's going for a flush fitment. So he bought himself a set of 9-inch wide Mustang Arellis. Give it a slap on there. Oh yeah, baby.
I.
Oh.
Oh
no.
Oh. What is happening?
Oh no, they don't fit.
How come I?
The wheels don't fit.
After some investigation, we see that the center bore is not appropriate. The center bore is off by a couple of millimeters. So we're gonna use this center bore adjustment tool right here. This is a router bit with a bearing on it. I'm just gonna try to shave off a little. Just gonna try to give her a little shave-a-roni. Oh yeah, baby. Look at that. Look at that, baby.
That's easier to shave than my nutsack, dude.
Okay.
So much easier.
No one wants to hear about your bald nutsack. Okay, we're gonna dump the shavings into your old wheel.
No dumping.
Okay, give that a testaroni, bud. I adjusted the center bore. Now that we know the wheels fit, we'll take them over to Big John's to get the right size tires put on.
Right now the tires are set up with two mega balloons for the rear and two super skinnies for the front. You're gonna end up looking like a four-door Grand Marquis funny car if we put them on like this.
Squat on your feet. Let me teach you the tire squat.
I'm not gonna do that. Shit.
Yeah, baby. Rob hooked us up with a set of brand new lug nuggets. Shit. Look it. No, now you cross thread it on. You gotta hand thread them.
Aw, bullshit.
See? Now look, you've made it. It's stuck now.
What is this horse shat?
Don't go winging them on there. That's the one missing a center cap?
Yeah.
Or are they both?
I have two broken center caps.
This one's good.
I got a glue one. I know, but the other one's missing. So now I'm fucking screwed and fucked.
Oh, they kept it? Broken?
No, they gave it to me and fucked.
Hey. You don't need to get so mad about it, all right?
Should have took $10 off my bill for that, dude.
They probably did. Oh, no, that was going to fall out.
Oh, you hosed it.
Now you got three bad center caps. I'm going to stop when it clicks.
No.
Like a professional, baby.
Woo-wee! Fits good. The fitment's not bad. Good.
Like it?
Yeah. Yes, I do.
Wow, don't act so excited. Ooh, look at those.
I'm excited, look. But I gotta go.
Look, fitness boy's gotta go on a run. Gotta put on his running shoes.
I got work. This fool's trying to hang out. He's trying to hang out.
I'm not trying to hang out.
Day.
You
made me do this.
Over here trying to play
while
around.
I'm on the job. I'm working and stopped what I'm doing.
That's it?
To help you with this project here.
That's all you had to do? Now I can cruise with the Hellcats. Time to go.
Now, Fitness Boy has himself that flush fitment all the kids on TikTok are raging about. He took this thing from a Mercury Grand Maquif to a Mercedes Grand Turismo.
Awful. Oh, no, Roger. Dreadful. No. Terrible. No. Stupid. Idiotic.
You're looking at a four-door Mustang, baby. Also known as a four-door butt stain.
Your sense of humor.
I've got my sense of humor. That was what my sense of humor.
Now I need to fix my too many car problem by fixing the Chevy and getting it the hell out of here before I go out of business.
Oh, take a look at this beauty. She could be yours for an astronomical fee. Come down and pick her on up. All right. I'm just gonna stick the whole bitch on jack stands because I have a couple screws and a back tire I need to take care of. Oh. I'll jack up the back by the Blumpkin. One of these tires has, I think, two screws in it. Oh yeah, look right here. Boom. Two. Somebody sabotaged me on purpose. Okay, so we'll pop this off, take it to Rob at Big John's. If I were to jam my fat head under here. Okay, so the air comes in here. This is the up valve, this is the down. See how this has the muffler on it? And this goes to the front bags. So there's a T. When this valve opens, it lets air in to the front bags. Then when it's closed, it closes. Then when this valve opens, it lets the air out. So this one is bad. So we gotta take this air dildo out of here. Hopefully this airline doesn't pop off and start swinging around, dicking around, and hit me in the eye. Oops. You know, what if it does that? I hear this one pissing air. I'm just gonna leave it. Let it leak itself out. I want an airline blown off. Okay, now these are attached with some bracketry. This is for the down. I'm gonna label these in case I get myself into a situation. So this one will go here. Looks like these fittings are all the same size and everything. The bracket probably won't work. This came with a new bracket. So I'll probably just put this bracket on while I put this together and just screw this to the frame.
Matter what you did, Doug.
Take a look at that, baby.
Like I said last episode, my too many car problem has led me on a spiritual journey within myself. Today's piece of spiritual car advice is: he who finances himself a project vehicle is a fucking idiot. I'm so fucked. Oh man, I'm so fucked. If you're the type of guy to get emotionally attached to your project vehicle, I suggest choosing a cheap platform that is easily replaceable. That way, your wife won't make you sell it because it's too expensive. And if it gets rammed, it's easily replaceable, and you can build a new one. How's that for some great advice? Don't be a fucking dumb bitch and finance a $50,000 car to work on and dump. What are you gonna dump another 20 grand?
You got problems now, Doug.
This is a tough one to sell. The problem is I bought this car before I earned it and financed it at an astronomical interest rate. Like one of those guys with them Hellcats. The payment is sucking me dry.
The tire's fixed. The valve is fixed. She's locked up, baby. Oh yeah, look at her go, baby. Look at her go.
The Chevy's ready for you to purchase and pick up. Hurry. Roll the emotional beauty shots. I could always be the one you wanna call when it's cold outside. I will always be the one that's right here standing by your side. Open up your heart and let me in. I promise not to break you. I promise I'll be all that you want. So let a major announcement to make. I lined up the next project vehicle for this hit show. I purchased the vehicle in preparation of whittling down my car collection to two vehicles, which may sound counterintuitive.
You got problems now, Doug.
What have I done? As soon as I sell the Chevy and the base van and get them out of here, I'll announce the next project. Then once the mule is done, we'll start the next project. We're not gonna start a project with in the middle of another project again. That would be stupid now, wouldn't it? Fucking goddamn stupid dick-licking son of a fucking dumb bitch. The reason I'm giving up on the bass van project is because my heart just isn't in it. I maxed out a credit card on it. It's been 3 years and I'm disgusted. But you should take it over and jump right into it. In fact, I'll give you a great deal. I'll suck your cock and give you 40 to get it out of here. I dropped the Bel Air off at Mark Zuckerberg, the car audio nerd's house, and reported it stolen.
No! No!
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
We're sending prizes out to our Patreon supporters, so be sure to join our Patreon to support the show so I don't go out of business. Jamie Ramcharan is getting a set of Meso 6.5 components, baby. Look at that. Shit. Autographed. Johnny Sherlock is getting this light up LED cock keychain. It can go this way or this way depending on your mood. With a set of penis socks. Dress socks, baby. Fitness crew socks. Fitness cock in your sock.